A visible police presence Saturday on the road leading to Ed and Elaine Brown's home. This as the couple holds a day-long concert on their property.
We had received information through the internet that the crowd could range from several hundred to maybe even 1,000 people. And our job is to keep the road open for emergency vehicles, fire and EMS.
The same fire and EMS who will no longer step foot onto the Browns' property. The police chief saying if one of these supporters was injured for any reason here today, they'd have to meet rescue crews at the bottom of the driveway.
With Brown supporters and people openly carrying guns and the threats and things that have been made in the past, it is not a safe area.
By midday Saturday, dozens of cars pulled into the driveway, some Brown supporters coming out to talk with police, as well as reporters who were not allowed inside.
Sort of having a good time, hanging out, enjoying the summer sun, and just listening to music.
I wanted to talk with Elaine and Ed Brown and other people that are interested in exposing the government corruption.
Police report only one incident, a traffic counter installed down the street to monitor the number of concert goers stolen, they believe, by someone inside.
We kind of suspect that supporters of Mr. Brown just feeling that they didn't want us to know number of cars.
As a law enforcement helicopter flies overhead, it's clear even without that traffic counter, authorities still have a good idea who's here.
At one point today, some tense moments on both sides when we all heard a series of gunshots go off in the distance. It turns out it was just someone on a neighboring property doing some target shooting, completely unrelated to today's concert. We're live in Plainfield. I'm Josh Davis, WMUR News 9.